On the first Saturday of each month for the past 35 years or so, our men have joined in prayer in one of the rooms of our church. For many of those years, I have prayed specifically behind, as the men can tell you, this old wooden pulpit, either behind it or beside it. 80 years ago, this pulpit stood at the Westside Baptist Church in West Palm Beach, just a few miles south of here. It was given, or offered to us, I should say, when their old building was sold. And I wanted it. And so Louise and I took it and we restored it in our garage when we lived in Egret. And since then, it has remained somewhere on church property. And of course, this pulpit has a special connection to our church, to all of us here, since it was Westside Baptist Church that had the vision to start a mission in Jupiter to begin what is now Beacon Baptist Church, and that was back in June of 1956. Some time ago, while I was reading through the old archives of the Westside Baptist Church, I came across some bulletins and some church announcements. And I was fascinated to read some of the guest speakers that stood behind this pulpit, men of God that Pastor Lamerson had invited to come to speak to his dear people. And it was a blessing to me to read that Lester Roloff stood here and sang and preached the Word of God. And I would see in another bulletin that John R. Rice was here, that he preached behind this pulpit, and Tom Wallace and Tom Malone and so many others who preached and taught and sang while standing here behind this pulpit. But one of the guests that I took special note of was the beloved songwriter and evangelist named Ira Stanphill. So many of the gospel songs that I sang when I first got saved as a 12-year-old, 13-year-old, were penned by Stanphill, including songs like "There's Room at the Cross for You," "He Washed Mine Eyes with Tears," "Mansion Over the Hilltop." The most familiar of his hymns was one that he sang from this pulpit right after he shared his testimony back on that warm evening in June of 1956. Ira Stanphill not only endured the trial of his wife leaving him and the ministry for worldly pursuits, and then subsequently her dying in a car accident, he also felt the sting of fellow believers and other preachers who criticized him and gave scorn as a preacher. But in addition to that, soon he battled his own physical trials with a brain tumor. One night when he was at his lowest point, Stanphill was driving his car to a meeting. And he was feeling like perhaps the critics were right and he's not married and maybe he should quit. He thought about the faithfulness of God and the omniscience of God. And it was then that he wrote the words to the song, "I Know Who Holds Tomorrow." You know, many times through these years, I have prayed behind this pulpit. Innumerable times. And as I've done so, I've thought about the fact that he sang those words. And I thought about the words. And the fact that that brother stayed faithful to the Lord until the day that he died. During COVID, when our men could not meet together for a few months on the first Saturday of the month, I went into the room alone and I prayed right here. And I thought during that time many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand. When Louise was taken home, when one of our dearest prayer warriors would attend always the men's prayer meeting when he was taking home, Jim McLean, it was by this same pulpit that I prayed and was reminded of that song and that man's faithfulness. And then one day, I'm looking at those archives long ago, and I realize that Mr. Stanphill sang that hymn to those dear people at Westside Baptist Church on the very week. It's right there in the bulletin. On the very week that they decided to have their first meeting to begin the ministry here in Jupiter and establish Beacon Baptist Church. And you know, I thought they had no idea what souls would be reached by the faithful efforts and sacrifices of beginning a church north of them. But I, for one, am grateful that they trusted God as they joined with him in singing those familiar words. As Stanphill sang, on that Sunday, June the 3rd, 1956, from this pulpit, every step is getting brighter as the golden stairs I climb. Every burden's getting lighter. Every cloud is silver lined. There the sun is always shining. There no tear will dim the eye. Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know who holds the future, and I know he holds my hand.
I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from its sunshine, for its skies may turn to gray. I don't worry o'er the future, for I know
say this to you. The trial you're going through, the storm you will go through, if you're faithful, if you go to the Lord, that answer to prayer from the Lord doesn't just impact you, it impacts all the other little ships around you. Your children, people you never know. There are things that happen in and around us in this life that we will never, ever understand. We will never see the purpose of it. But with God, you just know this, it always ends in triumph.